Perhaps for Mickey it'll be different. BBQ on blue side once again. Starting off with Lulu.
The Lulu ban, again, we talked about this last game. When they drafted the team composition that they did, it should have not been a Lulu. It should have been a Tahm Kench being banned away, because that was really the, I feel like, the turning champion in a way that really just decided so many team fights for the Rox Tigers. Rox now banning away Rumble. BBQ responds with the Shen, not giving that over too shy. And Camille now banned away.
Jin.
Jin being highlighted. Potentially taken away from Songyun. And I'm not entirely sure if target bans like Jin and Varus, etc., are that worthwhile anymore, especially not with the rise of Ezreal, the potential for Lucian. And I've heard murmurs of Kalista potentially being pickable in certain team compositions. Although, don't know, or I don't expect to see her anytime soon.
So no Varus this time around. And that means that they give over the Graves to Bless. Camera's on him. He doesn't look super confident or happy, like nothing that I can really read from him. With that Graves, he just doesn't look all so happy with the pick.
Yep. But every jungler in Korea can certainly play the Graves. He's definitely not going to be a stranger to it. And so now Rox might want to just respond with AD carry jungler and play it safe. They're highlighting the Elise right now. Rengar was open as well. So they're instead choosing to give Mighty Bear a more aggressive, favorable matchup.
Okay, well, no Rumble. That was the first ban for Rox, so they pick up Nautilus. They also picked up Mighty Bear for their team.
And so now BBQ handed back over the pick choice, and it's hard to see them wanting to give away a lot of information at this point. There's definitely no need for it. The Graves is extremely flexible into multiple different styles of team compositions. And there's the Ezreal being highlighted, and they could just go Ezreal Karma. That would be the safest route before progressing forward into the bans. Perhaps Ghost is a little bit nervous. He seems to be biting all the skin off his fingertips.
Now off his lips. He's just going at it, man.
He's going at it. He's biting. Yeah, and there is the Karma hover. We'll see if they do choose to lock that in. Never Ooh. Mind, they swap last second to the Maokai.
Okay. That is locked in.
Now, Karma's available, and I think that what they're potentially thinking is they'll give Rox Tigers, perhaps, the Karma, or they want to wait to see if Rox picks Malzahar, and then they can later respond accordingly with it, because now Tahm Kench is on the table again, and now if Rox locks in that Malzahar, they have Malz, they have Elise, they have Nautilus. Now this opens up for BBQ to actually take the Tahm Kench.
If Rox lets it get through, which is the big question. Will Rox recognize BBQ's mistake in Game 2 draft? They're going to start with the Zyra ban, but that doesn't mean that they couldn't ban Tahm Kench 5th.
So they're banning away Zyra, and now BBQ might want to just target AD carries here so they can give Ezreal a proper matchup. Varus and Jin already banned away. You can really force Songyun onto whatever it is that you want him to play.
Lucian?
Maybe. They're going to need a heavy hitting physical damage carry, either in mid or in that AD carry role, that marksman role. Jace is still on the table, and we know that it's a champion that Mickey can play. But Rox might be victim of putting Mickey on another mage, and that would just be horrific, because we saw what that meant in an earlier game where they had too much magic damage, and there's the Tahm Kench being banned away.
They're going into Maokai too, so I don't want to see it. I do not want to see it. I think you might be right about that, Jace. And you can see the Zed ban being hovered here by BBQ. Know that potentially Rox is looking towards an AD mid here.
You know, this probably means that Caitlyn will come out. Speak of the devil. There she is. So Caitlyn comes out, possibly. They have not yet locked it in, but again, they need something from that marksman role. And BBQ basically forced them into it. The only other choices here would be the Lucian, or honestly, with how it's currently set up, it could have been a spot for Kalista. This is a very thin spot for Kalista. Obviously, the Maokai can get on top of her with the Twisted Advance.
What about Sivir?
No, listen. Stop. No? Stop. Brendan.
You get some good engage
Brendan,
there.
We're in Korea. This isn't Europe.
It's happened before.
Brendan.
I've seen it with my own eyes.
Get off the desk. So now, BBQ handed back over. They're going to be able to get their Karma picked out up for themselves. And now, what is their last pick going to be? They have a lot of options that they could go with, and they're highlighting Syndra.
And that's locked. So, LS is very happy with this pick.
Well, I feel like this is a spot where Jace would have been fantastic, because he would have been extremely good against a lot of the options that are remaining. He can itemize extremely well, and I mean, we saw that they can definitely play Jace. Yes, that would have been a lot of physical damage, but outside of Nautilus, no one else is going to be able to itemize properly to defend against that assault.
What do you think about the Echo last pick here? I mean, Caitlyn definitely going to be a force to be reckoned with late in the game in terms of AD damage, but that's another kind of AP champion that you got in the mid lane. It's not like a, you know, it's not like a Syndra, and it will do well against the Syndra, speaking of which. They're also going to throw Teleport onto that Echo.
So they're opening up the gear for them to go into 1-3-1 later on. Maokai, not the best, actually. It's stopping the Echo split push, depending on how far ahead the Echo is or how far ahead he can get. It's not the worst, but it's not like he should ever really be able to kill Echo in that side split push. And so we'll take one last look at the team compositions before jumping into game number 3. Maokai, Graves, Syndra, Ezreal, and Karma for BBQ. And for the Rocks Tigers, Nautilus, Elise, Echo, Caitlyn, and Malzahar.
Looking forward to seeing Mickey on something like Echo. Can he do damage early on? How will Sangyun be on that Caitlyn later on as well? Guys, we're going to jump into the last game of the day, game 3 between the BBQ Olivers and the Rocks Tigers.
There's a traitor in the the crowd for BBQ as he roots for the Rocks Tigers and stands up while doing so.
Yeah, a couple of traitors. It's a group of them. You gotta weed them out. Maokai versus Nautilus in top lane. We see this like half the games, I swear. It's Maokai Nautilus. Over and over. These big frontline tanks.
Don't worry, Brendan. Reddit told me that Maokai was dead after the changes to his mana.
That's true.
Yep.
He just
this
can't
is just
lane
an
anymore,
illusion.
You know?
Yeah, he just can't.
It's just he's totally broken now.
Ghost actually, by the way, picking that, what's his name from Sailor Moon? Tuxedo Mask.
Oh, yeah, of course. How could I have forgotten?
Tuxedo Mask, and that's the best chroma on that Debonair Ezreal.
He's looking very slick. Let's see if it helps him out in the game. You know what they say, look good, play good. Well, it's look good, feel good, play good.
We'll see how all the laning phases go. Mickey has a nice matchup here in mid. See what Mighty Bear does for it. Now, Bless, if you look at all of the lanes, he should be the one to go into power farming mode. He can find some potential to try to kill Shy, maybe at level 5 or so in top lane, before the top laners would look for a teleport back into their lane. But the pressure is going to be on Mighty Bear to alleviate pressure in mid lane and make sure that Mickey doesn't get gutted early on.
You can see already Temps trying to poke him down as much as possible early on while he can. Ezreal Karma, ever pushing, ever bullying. Temp running a little bit low on mana. He's really trying to dish out that harass.
Lots of poke coming out for him, and it's interesting to note that Mickey doesn't have a corrupting potion start, so he's already out of biscuits or potions, and looked like Temp was actually going to recall. Should have been a little bit surprising.
Be waiting for the shields coming on up. Oh, looks like he missed a couple of CS there. Down in bottom lane, it looks like Ghost and Totoro still in the slight lead. They have that wave pushing into them. Ezreal should get that farm. Bless trying to come on in here, fight up against Mighty Bear on that Elise. Oh boy, Mickey eating a lot of damage. That last auto attack is pretty close, but not enough, and it will force him back. So wave is pushing into Temp. Looks like he'll just let it sit there.
Picks himself up another Doron's Ring in a refillable, and he teleports back to the lane. Temp doesn't have too much mana remaining, so he's gonna need a relief from Bless. We might see Bless go to Krugs and then to mid lane and open up a recall for Temp so that they're not wasting an entire wave.
Yeah, for sure. And Mickey ate a little bit of damage there. A couple of turret shots. And, well, you were talking about Bless heading towards mid. Mighty Bear coming on over here. Misses his cocoon. Both of these junglers going to throw down.
Well, the entire wave just went to waste.
Yeah.
And it's difficult to look at it and ask ourselves why. Because it's not like it's a small amount of gold or it's a negligible amount of experience. It's very easy for Bless to have just pathed there and picked it up. But he opted not to. He picks himself up the Raptor camp. He does have an experience lead over Mighty Bear. And again, he's not under an obligation to make anything happen. He can just keep power farming the jungle, eating up camps, wait until lanes are level 6 or so, and then look to make sparks fly.
Well, he's coming down towards here. It looks like the Tigers have done a better job of warding up the river so far. Bless looking to help out there. Thought Mighty Bear may have seen that ward go down, but it's not going to clear it out with the scrying plant. So far, very even at 6 minutes into the game. Some things going down. Mickey actually gonna jump the wall. This is that time winder. Allows Temp to, well, actually eats the stun. He's like, here you go. But Mickey not really able to get anything on the back of that. Trying to zone him out from using that time wander as much as possible, but you can see Mighty Bear comes up. helps push Tempt back, so he can throw that out. Pushes the wave. He's actually still on the chase. Mickey being forced to run far away to recall.
It's like Ghost and Totoro trying to perhaps deny the recall of Sangyun and Ki. Unable to do so, a ping goes down onto the wave, maybe showing intent to push out. Question mark ping actually appears in the right-hand side jungle. Sangyun stays, so right now there's not a lot of action that's unfolding. Talked about earlier on how that's normally going to be favorable for BBQ. Ghost going really aggressive.
It's pretty close, too. Sangyun getting extremely low. Still has... I think that's just one more potion. Can't quite tell. But enough to stick around. Ghost is going to be the one forced to recall here.
Les now picking up his red buff, maybe look to see if he can do something after that, as both bottom lanes are going to be coming off of a recall, but BBQ are going to be the ones that should have control over the lane, and they can choose what they want to do with it. Totoro, though, getting the worst end of that trade significantly, losing about 70% of his HP.
Yeah, he was really trying to keep that wave outside of the turret range, but what he didn't know was that there was a ward in the brush, which kept the aggro. Hold that thought. Mickey going on in, trying to get on to Tempt. There comes the unleashed power. Mickey, will he go on in more? Nope. Just going to back off into lane, trading ultimate for ultimate.
Mighty Bear trying to come in here and disrupt. And it looks like Bless got all of that. Mm-hmm. Infernal Drake is the first dragon of the game, by the way, and so as we approach the 10, 11 minute mark, it's very important that, well, they saw Elise rappel up.
Yeah. There's not many directions she can go. So I guess they just weren't paying attention. And this means that Mighty Bear may just be able to solo this Infernal Drake alone. I guess that's what solo means. So, be able to take this one out. And one last one. And the smite, and there's the Infernal Drake.
I mean, it's almost comical that they had the Scuttle Crab, they had the ward, they saw that Mighty Bear went in and didn't come out. So, unless you assume that he's going to recall, I can't fathom why they wouldn't prevent the Infernal Drake. Don't know really what to say about that, but...
just weren't paying
nice
attention,
pickup.
I guess.
Yeah, nice pickup for the Rocks Tigers. They're certainly going to like that Infernal Drake, and the next one of the game is yet another Infernal Drake.
Oh, nice. See the sparks fly in this one. Blue going to be handed over to Mickey, who you can see they're like kind of grouping up near that Infernal Drink. They should know that it was taken. But actually, it's just Ki and Mighty Bear going together as Ki has hit six. They're looking for a pick. Maybe they'll go mid. Now, Tempt us have both summoners, but there's the flash and a Ki. He's not fast enough. The cocoon follow up, and that's going to be first blood. Over to Mighty Bear.
Nice roam from Ki. Able to use that nether grasp and pick up the kill for his team. Looks like they really want to get mid tier one, but not quite.
Yeah, they're pushing on in, but actually Ki is going to back off. But there you go. Will be enough, even with the two shot barrage. First blood turret over the Tigers will be split between Mickey and Mighty Bear.
Damage coming out from Ki, absolutely fantastic by him. The amount of poke and damage he's been able to dish out on this Malzahar has been great so far in this game. We're at 11 minutes, and the Rocks Tigers have a little bit over a 1,000 gold lead, but they have the Infernal Drakes as well, or the Infernal Drake.
Could be Infernal Drakes. We'll see.
Reading a little bit too far ahead on the script.
Yeah, so sometimes that gets you. I understand.
Protobelt completed for Mickey. Does mean that his assassination attempts are significantly enhanced and his gap closed. And so this is the point in the game where, because the mid-tier one turret is opened up, Mickey can wave clear in. Attempt has to be more cautious. And BBQ needs to devote more ward coverage around mid so that they can properly contain Mickey, who has that teleport as well. And they can start making plays like this, because it's very difficult for BBQ to properly read this.
Gonna wait for the depth charge to hit. There is the nether grasp into the cocoon, and you're not getting away from that much CC. So, nice roaming so far out of the Rocks Tigers by Mighty Bear and E. But Sangyun, he doesn't have Ki around. He's going to force the teleport to come out of Mickey. Another turret goes towards the Rocks Tigers. That will be the top tier one.
Mickey comes down into bottom to just protect it. So far, his teammates have been doing an excellent job across the map. Sangyun rotates into mid to hold off the siege from Tempt, who's not really yet in a position to even offer any sort of a siege. He doesn't even have his first core item completed yet. Doesn't have blue available. It is coming up shortly. But right now, the Rocks Tigers are in a fantastic position in this game. Dragon's going to be coming up in 2 minutes. Mickey doesn't quite have his turret shredding abilities yet. He doesn't have that sheen or anything.
Coming soon. Crazy waiting for Shy. That won't be the most interesting lane in the game right now. Shy might just hang up there with his teleport waiting, defending that turret. Yeah, after those two turrets went down, not much else. You can see that there's a lot of pings onto that tier one bottom turret. So maybe that will be the next objective that Rox is looking towards. But they just got that nether grasp up again. And you can see that Ki and Mighty Bear are grouping up again. So hunting through the jungle, that's really the name of the composition right here in the mid game. Looking for picks. And BBQ should be very, very careful.
Right now, as long as they don't get picked off, they should be in a pretty good spot to look for that team fight around the dragon in about 30 seconds, as Temp's gonna have his blue buff. Top lane not in the worst of spots.
There's the pick squad going bot. But two-shot barrage really gonna help out with that, but the next wave will come in. And that will be the third turret going down. Now 3-0. The only unfortunate thing is that they can't use that gold for this next fight because they can't recall. But here we go. Let's see how BBQ wants to fight into this dragon. I don't think they can give another Infernal Drake away.
Definitely don't want to. Crazy is here, as is Shy. Problem is the angle of approach that BBQ is taking. This is just like that mistake in a previous game where they can get zoned out and then Rox can say see you later and go mid, provided they have a minion wave. This is such a difficult angle of approach.
We're going to have to see Bless maybe be the hero jumping on in, and no, it is going to go over to Mighty Bear and the Rox Tigers locking up Tempt here. Out comes the Unleashed Power, actually does get Caitlyn on the back. That's the only kill that they will find. Going 2-for-1, but the Tigers do pick up that Infernal Drake.
Credit to Rox for getting BBQ to angle themselves in that way leading up to that fight. It was the perfect area for Caitlyn to be the most effective. Sangyun did go down to Tempt Syndra, but they did pick up the one for one and the Infernal Drake, so I mean they come out massively ahead.
Yeah. That Cinder can be so silly sometimes. It's like you're losing the fight massively, but you just like point clicks your ADC and it's like, well, I guess you get a kill.
So here, Crazy went in, Bless went in, Bless tried to go out, Bless dies. That's pretty much the story of that.
Even with the exhaust.
Yeah, he wasn't able to do that much other than delete Songyun, but I mean the fight still went in Rox's favor. Next dragon of the game, an Ocean Drake, so gonna be a little bit of a pause. So it's not like a Mountain Drake or another Infernal Drake coming.
I was looking forward to more action. But Ocean Drake, not as cool as Ocean Man, as I mentioned before. Oh, they're going for the Rift Herald here. There's no vision for BBQ up here. They maybe can assume if they're paying a lot of attention to the fact that Mighty Pear hasn't shown himself for a while, but other than that, they should have no idea this is going on.
Mighty Pear able to solo this, most likely. Back into spider form, he has the spiderlings to help him out. And Mickey actually the one to slay it. He's gonna pick that up, and that's great for him in the split push. That's gonna be an almost 18-minute Rift Herald, so he should have that for the entire game. This is not Jhin Air that they're going up against, so 40 minutes is quite a long time.
You can see that wall of Caitlyn traps is still pretty obnoxious. But Ghost is going to safely farm behind it, trying to be the big farm leader on his team, competing with Mickey for the most CS in this. Oh, hold that thought. He's going on to Tamt. Not quite able to land all the damage. Not enough to burst him in one combo.
Be a little bit careful. He has his teleport available, so he's free to go wherever he wants, although it does look like Mickey is actually staying around, still has his ultimate even.
Let's see how far he wants to go. They may have assumed that he went back. Looking to just push in that wave. And there he does, so another one going on in.
Now it's just a battle of defense right now for BBQ. They need to try to hold on for quite a while longer and then deny Baron attempts from the Rock Tigers. Try to recover that way.
Yeah, very, very passive. Just farming the lanes, letting Rocks push it in. They know there's no way they can take a head-on fight, especially against Tigers with their lead and the two Infernal Drakes. Just don't go near them. Maybe if Tempt can find Songyun again. That's always an option.
Oh, Rocks Tigers.
Oh, boy. Well, this is one way to accelerate the game very fast. And if BBQ is playing this passive, but it seems like they've caught on to this. He is waiting in the wings to look for a pick. They're going to find Totoro. He will go
Mickey.
Down. Yeah, Mickey coming in from the left side will easily pick up Tam, so that's going to be a couple of kills. Nice play here from the Rocks Tigers to bait them in. Ghost now on the run, trying to flash away. Mickey trying to get him down. Bless will go down up top at the same time nearly as Ghost goes down. So that's four kills. Crazy didn't even enter that fight. And now they will return to the Baron.
Yeah, and they're going to easily be able to pick up this Baron. There's no hope for BBQ to stop this. Crazy's not even going to try to go over to it. And so this game three here is off to a super explosive mid game as Rocks Tigers almost at a 10K gold lead at 20 minutes. And this was a very good Baron play. You see the Caitlyn traps not allowing Bless or Ghost in. They locked up Totoro, got him. Tempt went too far forward into the Fog of War, got wrapped around by Mickey and deleted. Mickey was able to stay on top of Ghost. Ghost couldn't quite run away from him. Picked that up as Songyun up top, able to lay waste to Bless.
And now this game is beginning to get a little bit crazy, especially with the help of those two Infernal Drakes, as I keep saying. Like, when you get this kind of lead and have those kinds of Drakes with the Baron pushing in, doesn't matter how much MR you build, it's going to be a pretty nice landslide here for the Rocks Tigers right now, unless they do make some kind of mistake here.
Well, if we're looking at the items across most of the champions, a lot of the items are very defensive right now, and they don't really have any spikes going for them. So BBQ not in a position to really stop a Baron Siege. Matt Caitlin is going to do a lot of work. Game just accelerated a little bit too quickly for them, and they have not found any way to stabilize. And more turrets are poised to fall now. No one even has a QSS, by the way. Everyone is susceptible to Key's Malzahar.
They just can't afford it. They're like desperately trying to scrounge together whatever they can find on the floor of Summoner's Rift. Any golds they can scrounge up, but not being too successful. It looks like they may make a stand here. Tempt does get stunned. They're going to be able to clear this wave. But meanwhile, you got Mickey up in top. Caitlyn, Sangyun is in mid, pushing that one in. And the assistance ping's going down, but he's setting up the wall of traps once again. And Kia's right there. We got a lot of damage.
Almost goes down. Now Shy and Mighty Bear. And this is just them being way too far ahead at too early of a point. It's one thing to be 10k ahead. It's another to be 10k ahead at 23 minutes.
Yeah, definitely not the standard. Now, Mickey may have paid for it with his life. The Unleashed Power comes out after he's able to chrono shift back, but actually he turns it back and brings down Tempt with him. And meanwhile, the rest of his team was pushing inhibitors. Here comes Shy. He is trying to get onto Blast. Looks like he will survive Crazy, just not tanky enough. Will be shredded there. Dredgeline will miss, but Rocks Tigers continue to push.
Looks like the Rocks Tigers could even potentially push on into a victory here with Sangyun still alive. Key almost goes down. They might only just get one Nexus turret. Never mind, Bless.
Oh, close.
He almost was a food drive.
So, looks like not even the Nexus turret. Nice try, though. They had that wave with Baron.
They only got two inhibitors, Brendan.
Yeah. It was a nice try, I guess.
Sangyun now gonna net into the dragon. He doesn't even care. He doesn't even want it. That dragon can live. Now, with the items that they have, you can see the QSS even being picked up by Sangyun. This is something I talk about a lot also. Take a look at the Guardian Angel on Mighty Bear and just all the defensive items that are coming out. When you're this far ahead, you're already dealing unnatural amounts of damage due to either base level advantages or because you're too far accelerated, you already have damage items that you're not supposed to have at that point in the game. And if you're capable of winning without those advantages, then just add on defense and you win anyway, because it really reduces the opponent's chance to just remove you from the field and then have your champion's gold be absent in the advantage.
But when you're in solo queue, it looks a lot cooler to one-shot somebody instead of living. So
okay.
I choose to pick up Majaya's Soul Stealer. That's my my go-to item for for when I'm really far ahead. Seems like maybe these guys are a bit smarter than I am. going for the push up in top lane. Now, this is kind of the follow-up to what we saw occur for the first 25 minutes of the game.
Mickey almost deletes half of a turret in just one combo with that Lich Bane and that Herald. Does have to flash away, but it doesn't matter. The inhibitor up in top is falling.
Oh, Tempt. It's getting close. Shy is doing crazy amount of damage too with the help of Mickey. And let's see how many kills the Rox Tigers can pick up on the back end. That's going to be three. Caitlyn is one-shotting these guys as they just don't have enough health to survive. Trying to get as many kills as possible before the game ends. And can they get any more? Dredgeline is going to miss. Doesn't look like they will, but the Rox Tigers will pick up the 2-1 victory in tonight's series over BBQ.
And what a clean third game. Two kills only for BBQ able to be picked up in that series. 26-minute win. Honestly, it almost looks like the last time these two teams met, the final game of the night to conclude, just extremely one-sided. Mickey on the Echo having a phenomenal performance. Don't know if he'll get the MVP. I would assume that he would, most likely. He doesn't have the highest kill participation. Yeah. Key, though, on that Malzahar had a lot of clutch nether grasps. And Rox were able to close out the series. BBQ need to learn how to play the macro game because it is pretty evident at this point so far in LCK Spring that they just fall apart when it gets to that stage. And Bless really needs to refine his other champions because it's kind of unacceptable to have such a heavy reliance on non-meta junglers at this level of play.
The other part of this is that the matchup was very important for BBQ. You can see they're kind of crushed because now they're almost definitely going to the relegation matches because Rox Tigers was 7th place. BBQ is 8th place. So now they're kind of designated as that 8th place team ahead of Jinder Green Wings and Konnu Monster, but behind Rox Tigers. And losing this game is only going to hurt their record. So unless they win the next three, the Rox Tigers lose the next two, or rather the next three, I think it is, for them as well. That should be the way it goes down for 8th place and 7th place. So, not too happy with that. But guys, we are going to go straight to the MVP interview in just a minute. So, stay tuned for that.